Hello everyone, myself Parneet Kaur Sandhu, lecturer in chemistry from Meritorious School, Patiala. I welcome you all in today's chemistry class. Today's our topic of discussion is electron gain enthalpy. So first is lecture flow. Under this topic, we will discuss about its definition, successive electron gain enthalpy, factors which affecting electron gain enthalpy, periodic trends, that is its variation along a period and within a group. And last is assignment that is related to this particular topic. So first of all, we will start with its definition part. Suppose this is a atom having positively charged nucleus in its center, and here is a negatively charged electron. As negative and positive charge always attract each other, so this negatively charged electron get attracted towards this positively charged nucleus, and this electron get added to the outermost shell of the atom. During this addition, there is a change in enthalpy, or you can say some amount of energy is released, which is known as electron gain enthalpy. कि जब भी हम किसी भी इलेक्ट्रॉन को किसी एटम में ऐड करेंगे तो उस स्टेप में क्या होगा, कुछ ना कुछ एनर्जी रिलीज होगी, जिसको हम क्या नाम देंगे, इलेक्ट्रॉन गेन एन्थैल्पी. फ्रॉम दिस वी कैन इजीली डिफाइन इलेक्ट्रॉन गेन एन्थैल्पी. नाउ कम टू द डेफिनेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन गेन एन्थैल्पी. इलेक्ट्रॉन gain enthalpy of an element is defined as amount of energy released when a neutral isolated gaseous atom accepts an extra electron to form the gaseous negative ion, that is the anion. कि जब भी हम किसी neutral isolated गैसियस एटम में किसी एक्स्ट्रा इलेक्ट्रॉन को ऐड करेंगे तो उस स्टेप में क्या होगा, कुछ ना कुछ एनर्जी रिलीज होगी, जिसको हम क्या बोलेंगे, इलेक्ट्रॉन गेन एन्थैल्पी. एंड आफ्टर द एक्सेप्टेंस ऑफ दैट एक्स्ट्रा इलेक्ट्रॉन, दैट पर्टिकुलर एटम गेट कन्वर्टेड इनटू द नेगेटिव आयन, दैट इज द एनायन. हियर इन द डेफिनेशन आई हैव यूज्ड what neutral, isolated and gaseous one. Why the atom should be neutral, isolated and gaseous during the addition process? First is neutral, that means no charge. During the addition process, the atom should have no charge, because it's easier to add an electron to the atom which is having no charge rather than the atom which is having a some charge, either positive or negative. So the atom should be neutral one. Second is isolated, which means single atom. So it's better to study any property on the isolated atom rather than on the group of atoms, because in the group of atoms the behavior of the atom will change. So it's better that the atom should be isolated. Third is gaseous, that is isolated atom always found in the gaseous form. So due to this, during the addition process the atom should be neutral, isolated and gaseous one. So next, electron gain enthalpy provides a measure of the ease with which an atom adds an electron to form an ion as represented by the equation. Suppose this is a neutral, isolated, gaseous X atom and this electron is to be added to this. After the addition of this electron, it gets converted into the X negative ion and some energy is released in this step, which is known as electron gain enthalpy, which is denoted by the symbol delta EG H. EG means electron gain, H is enthalpy. One more point over here, greater the amount of energy released in the above process, higher is the electron gain enthalpy of the element. Kis step mein jitni zyada energy release hogi, electron gain enthalpy ki value utni hi zyada hogi. Clear? So, depending on the element, the process of adding an electron to the atom can be either endothermic or exothermic. Endothermic means we have to supply some amount of energy during the addition of an electron. So in this case, electron gain enthalpy would be positive in magnitude. Or exothermic is that energy is released when we add an electron to the atom. So in this case, electron gain enthalpy would be negative in magnitude. And it entirely depends upon the nature of the element that the addition process could be endothermic or exothermic. For many elements, energy is released when an electron is added to the atom. Therefore, for such elements, electron gain enthalpy is negative. For most of the elements of the periodic table, energy is released when we are going to add an electron to the atom. So, if energy is released, then the process is exothermic. So, in that cases, the electron gain enthalpy is negative in magnitude. But there is a one exceptional case, that is the noble gases, which have large positive electron gain enthalpy. This is because of their stable electronic configuration. As noble gases have general electronic configuration as NS2NP6, and it's clear from their electronic configuration that their outermost shell is fully filled. And due to this, there is no vacant space in their valence orbital, and the additional electron has to be placed in an orbital of higher energy shell, which ultimately produces a highly unstable electronic configuration. That is not easier one. क्यों? क्योंकि एक चीज ऑलरेडी स्टेबल फॉर्म में है, वो क्यों एक एक्स्ट्रा इलेक्ट्रॉन एक्सेप्ट करके खुद को अनस्टेबल फॉर्म में कन्वर्ट करेगी? सो इन दैट केस वी हैव टू सप्लाई सम अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी टू ऐड एन एडिशनल इलेक्ट्रॉन. एज एनर्जी सप्लाइड इन दिस केस, सो द प्रोसेस इज एंडोथर्मिक. देयरफॉर द इलेक्ट्रॉन गेन एंथैल्पी ऑफ नोबल गैसेस इज पॉजिटिव. Now next is successive electron gain enthalpy. When one electron is added to an atom, that is this, it becomes negatively charged ion. And the enthalpy of this first step is known as the first electron gain enthalpy. As in the most of the cases, energy is released, so the first electron gain enthalpy is negative in magnitude. If we want to add the second electron to this negatively charged ion, that is not the easier process because both are having the same charge and same charge always repel each other. So this second electron experiences repulsive forces because of the electrons already present in that outermost shell. And to overcome these repulsive forces, between them we have to supply some additional energy. Hence, the energy has to be supplied for the addition of second electron. And due to this, the second electron gain enthalpy of an element is positive in magnitude. Similarly, if we want to add the third electron to this 2x2 negatively charged ion, then again we have to supply some energy to overcome the repulsive forces between them. So again, the electron gain enthalpy of this third step is also positive in magnitude. For example, when an electron is added to sulfur atom to form S negative ion, it releases energy. So the first electron gain enthalpy of sulfur is negative in magnitude, whereas energy is required when another electron is added to S negative ion to form S2 negative ion. So as energy is supplied, so due to this, the second electron gain enthalpy of the sulfur is positive in magnitude. Similarly, the case of the oxygen also. The first electron gain enthalpy of oxygen is negative in magnitude, while the second is positive in magnitude. So from this, it is concluded that first electron gain enthalpy is generally negative in magnitude, while second, third, and so on, successive electron gain enthalpy is always positive in magnitude. The next is the factors. There are mainly three factors which affecting the electron gain enthalpy. First is atomic size, second is nuclear charge, third is electronic configuration. So first is atomic size. Here are two atoms, one is the smaller in size, another is the bigger in size. And this is the outermost shell which receives the incoming electron. It's the incoming electron, and here is a positively charged nucleus. As it is seen in the case of the small atom, the distance between the nucleus and the outermost shell which receives the incoming electron is less. But as the size of atom increases, the distance between this nucleus and the outermost shell which receives the incoming electron increases. So as a result, the force of attraction between the nucleus and the incoming electron decreases, and hence the electron gain enthalpy becomes less negative. कि जैसे जैसे साइज बढ़ता जाएगा, जो फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन है वो क्या होती जाएगी, कम होती जाएगी. सो जो इलेक्ट्रॉन गेन एंथैल्पी है वो भी क्या होती जाएगी, इट बिकम्स लेस एंड लेस नेगेटिव. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज द सेकंड फैक्टर, दैट इज द न्यूक्लियर चार्ज. एज द न्यूक्लियर चार्ज इंक्रीजेस, द फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन बिटवीन द न्यूक्लियस एंड द इनकमिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन इंक्रीजेस. एंड ड्यू टू दिस, the atom has a greater tendency to attract and accept the additional electron. That's why the electron gain enthalpy increases, that is, it becomes more and more negative. कि जैसे जैसे हमारा न्यूक्लियर चार्ज बढ़ता जाएगा, it becomes more and more negative. Third is the electronic configuration. Elements having exactly half filled, that is p3, d5, f7, or completely filled orbitals, that is p6, d10, f14, are very stable. And due to this, we have to supply some energy to add an electron to these stable orbitals. Hence, their electron gain enthalpies have large positive values, since they do not accept the additional electron so easily. So next is the periodic trends. First is the variation along a period. Electron gain enthalpy becomes more and more negative from left to right in a period. This is because as we move across a period from left to right, the atomic size decreases and the nuclear charge increases. And both these factors tend to increase the force of attraction between the nucleus and the incoming electron. Hence, electron gain enthalpy becomes more and more negative in a period from left to right. So next is variation within a group. The electron gain enthalpy becomes less negative as we move down a group. This is because as we move down a group, both the atomic size and the nuclear charge increases. But the effect of increase in atomic size is much more pronounced than the nuclear charge. So here is a smaller size atom. The distance between them is less, but in case of the large atom, this distance is more. So the force of attraction between them decreases, hence the electron gain enthalpy becomes less negative. So as we move from left to right in a period, the electron gain enthalpy will increase, but as we move from top to bottom in a group, it will decrease. So next is the important trends. First is halogens have the most negative electron gain enthalpy. This is because of their electronic configuration. Halogens have general electronic configuration, that is NS2 NP5. They are having one electron less than the stable electronic configuration. They can acquire the nearest stable noble gas configuration by accepting an extra electron. And due to this, halogens have more negative electron gain enthalpy. Halogens consist of members, that is fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine. So as we move from fluorine to chlorine, there should be decrease in the value of electron gain enthalpy, but actually this is not the case. Actually, as we move from chlorine to iodine, the electron gain enthalpies become less and less negative due to the corresponding increase in their atomic radii. The expected order would be fluorine, followed by chlorine, followed by bromine, followed by iodine. But the actual order is chlorine, followed by fluorine, followed by bromine, followed by iodine. That is, the electron gain enthalpy of fluorine is less than that of the chlorine. As the distance of the nucleus from the subshell, that is from chlorine to iodine, which receives the additional electron, increases, the force of attraction between the nucleus and the incoming electron decreases, and hence the electron gain enthalpy becomes less and less negative as we move down the group from chlorine to bromine to iodine. So the expected order is this, but the actual is this. It is clear from the picture also, the value of electron gain enthalpy of fluorine is 322, whereas of chlorine is 349. That is, the electron gain enthalpy of fluorine is less than that of the chlorine. Why is it so? This is because of its small size. As a result of its small size, the electron-electron repulsion in the relatively compact 2p subshell of fluorine are comparatively large as compared to the 3p subshell of the chlorine. Hence, the incoming electron is not accepted with the same ease as is the case with the chlorine. कि जो incoming electron है वो इतनी आसानी से fluorine के केस में accept नहीं होगा. Why? Because of the electronic repulsions. But in case of chlorine, it is easily accepted. So this is the first electron gain enthalpy of few elements. It is clear from this also that as we move from top to bottom in a group, the electron gain enthalpy will become less and less negative. This is because of increase in their atomic size. But as we move from left to right in a period, the electron gain enthalpy would become more and more negative, except in the case of the noble gases. In that case, it is the positive in magnitude. So, second important trend is the electron gain enthalpy of noble gases is positive. This is because of the atoms of these elements have completely filled subshell. As a result, there is no room in their valence orbitals and the additional electron has to be placed in an orbital of next higher shell, which produces unstable electronic configuration. As a result, energy has to be supplied to add an additional electrons. So that's why the electron gain enthalpy of noble gases is always positive in magnitude. So now it's a time for the assignment. So first is, explain why electron gain enthalpy of oxygen is less than that of sulfur. Electron gain enthalpy of fluorine is less than that of the chlorine. The elements of second period, that is oxygen or fluorine, have smallest atomic size among the elements in their respective group. Jo oxygen or fluorine hai, they are the elements of the second period and they are the smaller in size among the elements of the respective group. Due to this, when an electron is added to oxygen or fluorine, the added electron goes to the smaller 2p subshell and it suffers a significant repulsion from the other electrons present in this level. So the electron is not accepted as a much ease in this case. While in case of sulfur or chlorine, the added electron goes to the 3p sub level, which occupies a larger region of space, and due to this the electron-electron repulsion is much less in this case. That's why the incoming electron is easily accepted in these cases, and due to this the electron gain enthalpy of oxygen or fluorine is less than that of the succeeding element. The next is, which of the following pair of element would have more negative electron gain enthalpy? Explain. Nitrogen or oxygen? The electron gain enthalpy of oxygen is highly negative, while that of nitrogen is slightly positive. This is because of their electronic configuration. Electronic configuration of nitrogen is 1s2, 2s2, 2p3, while that of oxygen is 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. The electronic configuration of nitrogen is quite stable since it has the exactly half filled 2p orbitals and hence has no tendency to accept an extra electron. Hence, energy has to be supplied to add an extra electron. Thus, electron gain enthalpy of nitrogen is slightly positive. And this is the electronic configuration of oxygen. And in the case of oxygen, the electronic configuration is not quite stable because it is not the exactly half filled, but it has higher charge and lower atomic size than nitrogen. Due to the lower atomic size, the force of attraction between the nucleus and the incoming electron is more, and hence it has a high tendency to accept an extra electron. Thus, electron gain enthalpy of oxygen is highly negative. Now, it's a time to say thank you.